Reheat Rankine cycle is one of the method of improving efficiency of Rankine cycle. So now in a reheat Rankine cycle, the steam is expanded in a number of stages. After each stage of expansion, the steam is reheated in the boiler, then it expands in the next stage of the turbine and is finally exhausted to the condenser. That is the process. So now I am going to draw, this is important. In a reheat Rankine cycle, the steam is expanded in number of stages. Remember this. And now I am going to draw a layout of reheat Rankine cycle. Now, same as simple Rankine cycle, the reheat Rankine cycle also contains boiler, this is boiler, and the pump, which is also present in the simple Rankine cycle. Same as that, we are having pump here, pump from 1 to 2, this is 1 to 2, this is boiler. After boiler, we had turbine here, same as simple Rankine cycle. Now this is high pressure HP, high pressure turbine. This is high pressure turbine. Now after the boiler exit, the working fluid goes to the high pressure turbine and gives some work. And then after coming out from the high pressure turbine, the steam goes again into the boiler for reheating purpose. It goes into the boiler again. Here it gets reheated and then comes back and it passes through the low pressure turbine. This is low pressure turbine. Low pressure turbine. Now after passing through low pressure turbine, this is 3, so this will be 4, and then coming out, this will be 5, this is 5. This passes through the low pressure turbine and it after the low pressure turbine it goes directly into the condenser. This is 6, it goes directly into the condenser. We know already the condenser look like this. This is a condenser and this goes in, let me draw like this. This is condenser. Condenser output will be 1 and this is inlet. Now cooling water supply to take heat, cooling water supply in, cooling water outlet. And this is a simple, this is reheat. This is reheat Rankine cycle. So this is reheat Rankine cycle. We derive the equations, the required equations and everything while solving a problem. This is reheat Rankine cycle. The information all you need. Now here H1 will be at a lower enthalpy than 2. And 2 will be at higher enthalpy, 3 will be at higher enthalpy than 2, 4 will be at lower enthalpy than 3. That means we'll see everything while solving problem in the on reheat Rankine cycle. So that's it. Next. Yes. Okay. Now, first of all, let me draw the TS diagram of Rankine reheat cycle. Temperature on y-axis, entropy on x-axis. Now vapor boom, this is the case. Now from 1 to 2, this is pressurizing the working fluid, and then 2 to 3, this is the constant pressure line. It goes here, this is the point 3, and then 3 to 4, is the expansion in turbine, and then 4 to 5 is the reheat, 5 to 6 this is isentropic process, 5 to 6 is 3 to 4, 4 to 5, 5 to 6 is expansion of the low pressure turbine, and 6 to 1 here, 1 is on the fluid line, 6 to 1 F, G, 6 to 1 is the condenser. Now the pressure here they have given in the information, Rankine reheat cycle has a net power output of, given that net power output P output is equal to how much, 150 megawatt, here it is 150 megawatt, and steam enters the high pressure turbine. This is a high pressure turbine, this line is high pressure turbine, this line is a low pressure turbine, high pressure turbine, yes, steam enters the high pressure turbine at 10 megapascals. That means here T3, they have given P3 is equal to 10 megapascal and T3 is equal to 500 degree centigrade. Now what they have given, the steam enters the low pressure turbine at 1 megapascal and 500 degree centigrade. So this is the entrance of the low pressure turbine, therefore P5 they given that 1 megapascal, and T5 they have given that 500 degree centigrade. That means 3 and 4 at same temperature, 3 and 5 at same temperature. And then what they have given, steam leaves the condenser, this is the condenser line, steam leaves the condenser as a saturated liquid at a pressure of 10 kilopascal. That means this pressure line is 10 kilopascal line, this pressure is 10 kilopascal, and this pressure what they have given, this is 2 to 3, this pressure is how much, this pressure is 10 megapascal, and then this line, this is also a constant pressure line, it look like this is the constant pressure line, this line, let me draw this as a dotted line, this is this pressure line is 1 megapascal. Okay, these things are important while solving problem. This is TS diagram of reheat Rankine cycle. Now one thing I have already told in the previous videos, that is whenever you find a Rankine cycle, you have to solve for enthalpies at all points. That's it. Then your problem will be solved. Enthalpies at all points. Okay. Our aim is to find enthalpies. Enthalpy at all points. Enthalpy at all points. This is our aim while solving the Rankine cycle, any vapor power cycles.